Locate Comstock Hall on the biology quad and find room 1109. When you walk in, turn the lights on and use the remote control to turn on the recording studio lights. When you walk into the studio, you will find two microphones. They are both called Blue Yeti microphones. Make sure that the red light is not blinking because it means that the microphone is muted. On the back of the microphone, you can find the gain and the settings for the recorder. On the wall, you can find some descriptions about the recording modes. The gain should be set around in the middle, and the recording mode should be the cardioid. Both microphones are USB microphones connected to this laptop. The podcast recorder has no password, just hit enter and click on the Hindenburg recording software that you are going to use. Make sure that the microphone device is recognized and you are not accidentally using the built-in mic of the computer. Hindenburg has four channels. You will probably use the speak and the interview channels. Make sure you choose the right microphones for each of them, which is usually the stereo microphone and the Yeti stereo microphone too. You can pick the stereo function for both of them. If you are just recording yourself, just use one of the channels, speak. Otherwise, when you are interviewing someone, pick the interview channel as well. Click on the little red buttons and then click on the larger red button on the bottom of the screen to start the recording. The small red buttons, just choose the channel, and the larger red button actually starts the recording. You can see the peaks of your recorder. In this case, you see that I'm using the microphone with the speak function, therefore the peaks are higher, although the other microphone is picking up some of the signals as well. Do not worry about that. When I start to record with the second microphone, the gray microphone that's connected to the interview channel, you see that the peaks are higher there. You can stop the recording. If you'd like to mute any of the channels, just click on the M and those channels are going to be muted. It's a really good function when you are editing different channels. You need to click on the recordings in order to select them. Then they will turn yellow. In order to edit them, very often you need to zoom in so you can see individual words or even letters as peaks so you can edit them out. When you click on the play, you can listen to your interview, and it should be between minus 12 and minus 6 decibels on the scale on the bottom of the screen. Again, when you are editing, make sure you edit both of the channels at the same time, otherwise they will be off. So you can click on it or shift click on them to select both. So for example, here I select them and cut out a piece. Again, you just click on it and drag the cursor. You can also copy a section and then move the cursor somewhere else and insert that section there. If you click on clear, it's going to delete it, but don't forget, there will be a gap there in your edits. You want to export these recordings, so click on export and pick an MP3 file, the highest quality possible. MP3s are great because they are very versatile and you will be able to use them in many other softwares. Make sure you save it to the desktop so you know which file is yours. If you just would like to select a section and export that selection, Hindenburg allows you to export selection. Just follow the same description, pick the MP3 format and the highest quality. In order to save your recording so you can come back and edit it later, you want to save it in a Hindenburg files format. So name it correctly and save it on the desktop so you can transfer it to your own computer. When you are done, just close the software. Your recording is going to be on the desktop, so you can just go ahead and open it up and return to editing. Don't forget that some of those files are going to be in a different folder. So when you transfer the recordings from this computer, make sure you transfer all the files. Feel free to use the computers in 1109 for editing. They all have the Hindenburg software. And if you go to the Hindenburg website, you can find excellent tutorials about how to edit these files. So when you are done, just please close Hindenburg, close the laptop, you don't need to turn it off, and as you walk out, make sure you turn the light off, so both the whisper room and room 1109 is dark. You want to make sure you lock the door, don't lock yourself out if you want to come back, and if you have any questions, email us at biolabs@cornell.edu.